as individuals in the desert, they are predominantly personal in their individual and determined beliefs.
Following from among
and state exactly what a vibration is. If I tell you that vibration is an illusion, as sensory perception is known by the soul to be, then you comprehend limited as all human beings are by the reactions of a series of vehicles, all of them instruments of perception. If I tell you that vibratory reaction is new to our possessing a mechanism which is responsive to impact, I am answering your question in part, but if this is true, what does it mean to you and from whence comes the impact? If I give you the scientific definition, which you can discover in any good textbook on light, color or sound, I am doing work that you can do yourself, and for that I have no time. In my books are Copyright 1998 Also Trust 220, A Treatise on the Seven Rays, Volume 4, Esoteric Healing. Several definitions of vibration, either by inference or divine, and these you might search for, and upon them you might meditate. If I elucidated for you here the relation between the self and the not self, between awareness, that which is aware, and that of which it is aware, I am covering ground which a careful study of the Veda would aid you in comprehending. Let simplicity be your guide and one point of love your their common knowledge and aims, but who will all express this to the best of their ability in their own peculiar field, in their own peculiar way and with their own peculiar terminology. It is this objective life unity that is of interest to the teachers on the inner side of life, and the production of a network of true healers all over the world. A fresh start is now being made. Thank you. in the person and the body, desire and appetite, the more easily you will be photographed after passing over if anyone wants to. Photograph them, and the more advanced the person, the more difficult it will be to get a photograph. Copyright 1998 Moses Trust. 224. The Treatise on the Seven Rays, Volume 4, Esoteric Healing. As regards the use of radio as a means of communication with the strobe of all consciousness. Most men live today in the world of effects, and have no idea that they are effects. Some few are now beginning to live in the world of meaning, whilst disciples and those functioning in the world of the hierarchy are aware, or are steadily becoming aware, of the causes which produce the effects which meaning reveals.
Thank you.
reality is a real benefit. Patients must learn to recognize and accept the law of karma. 2. Fear is needless. One of the first objectives of the healing agent should be to aid the patient to achieve a happy, sane, expected outlook upon his future, no matter what that future may bring. It will be obvious too that there lies before you the opportunity to bring a new attitude to the whole problem of disease and healing and to train humanity in a better and happier sense of proportion where disease and health are concerned. It will also be obvious to you that the word restitution concerns the high art of restoring to the patient that which he needs in order correctly to face life. Physical body and on the physical plane are the continuity of life on the other level, unseen by the average man and regarded as problematical and intangible. Restitution may also involve the righting of wrongs by the patient, prior to receiving what you regard as successful treatment, but it primarily concerns the effect of the healing group when it first establishes contact with the one to be healed. Sometimes, when the patient's karma indicates it, the will to live must be restored to him. In other cases, the rejection of fear of life or fear of death must be induced, bringing with it the restoration of courage, the restoration of end. Copyright 1998, Lucis Trust. 230. The Treatise on the Seven Rays.
Yeah.
This stage of condition of all living, and a major part of their work will be the enough to that time zone, however, completely destroy the fear of death. In the case of the psychos working in a master's ashram, even this process of integration will constitute no barrier. In the next few pages I will give some teaching on what might be called the art of dying and so expand what I said in a treatise on white magic. Present attitudes to death. I undertook to take up with me the processes of dying and to consider a little more fully the factor of death. The most familiar experience for the physical brain that recall it and realize it in the life of the reincarnating entity or soul. Let me make some comments as to the attitude of man to the experience of restitution. This is a peculiarly called word, largely used by the initiate when speaking of death. The outstanding attitude associated with death is one of fear. This fear is based upon the, at present, mental uncertainty as to the fact of immortality. Beyond the proven fact of some form of survival, established by the psychical research group. Copyright 1998 Research Trust. 235. The Treatise on the Seven Rays. Volume 4. Esoteric Healing. Immortality is a permanent existence of what we usually mean when we speak of the I, remains as dead in the realm of wishful thinking or of belief. Upon religious affirmation based on rationalizing the matter, and on the more scientific approach which argues that economic necessity requires that which has been so long and evolving and which is the culminating result of the evolutionary process cannot be lost. It is interesting to note that there is no evidence upon our planet of any higher evolutionary product than that of the human kingdom. Even for the materialistic thinker, the uniqueness of man is to be found in his various stages of consciousness and in his capacity to present for investigation all stages of consciousness, from that of the illiterate savage, through all the intermediate stages of mental effectiveness up to the most advanced thinkers and geniuses, capable of creative art, scientific discovery and spiritual perception. Putting it very simply, the question which the theme of death arouses is, where is the I, the occupying tenant of the body, when that body is relinquished and disintegrates? Is there, in the last analysis, an occupying tenant? Human history records the endless search for assurance upon this subject. This search culminates today in the numerous societies which are on the seven rays, volume 4, esoteric healing. Not existent. This fear the illusory nature of all findings based on astral clairvoyance. The recognition of a pronounced time factor, and the constant emphasis laid upon timing, are characteristic of all highly developed people and incarnation and ability of lower, concrete minds are powerful in caliber. Children and child races on the one hand, and those highly advanced people whose abstract lead up to a perception until contact will enable him to see. Copyright 1998 Wolf of Strife. 244. The treatise on the seven.